Today, you're going to learn four strategies to change your IP address. I'm going to show you the best and worst ways to change your IP address in just a few simple steps. Make sure you stay up to date with Security Gladiators by hitting the subscribe button and hit the bell for notifications, and don't forget to like or comment if you like our videos. By following our super easy video, you can be sure that your surfing remains anonymous and protected, but choose not to properly protect yourself and you risk being compromised. Okay, if you searched how to change your IP address, well, you probably already know what an IP address is, so I won't go into the technicalities of it. But in case you don't, essentially, an IP is a unique number that is assigned to a device that is connected to the internet. When you access the internet, your IP address is broadcast for all to see. This means every website you visit and every network you use will know your IP address, and they can use it for a number of different purposes. Some are completely fine, others, well, quite frankly, you should be very worried about. But guess what? IP addresses are not written in stone and can be changed. And obviously, this is a good thing because you might want to watch content that's only available in another country, or maybe you're away and you want to watch content that's only available back at home. For example, say you're holidaying in Australia and you want to watch something on BBC iPlayer, which is only available in the UK. To bypass the geo-blocking restrictions, you'll need to change your IP to the one that's registered in the location you want to appear to be located in. Geo-blocking is also used by the likes of Netflix, HBO, Hulu, ABC iView, and several others. Lots of others, actually. Also, appearing from a different location can help you with cheaper airline tickets, software subscriptions, and in some cases, it can even remove taxes. You can also unblock sites that aren't necessarily geo-restricted. Places like schools and universities and where you work are notorious for this. Also, by changing your IP address, you can bypass online censorship. Very important if you live in an authoritarian regime and you want to access things like Facebook, Twitter, or Google, or even just sensitive news articles that you might not be able to access in your country, depending on where you might live. Let's not beat around the bush, though. One of the main reasons why people want to change their IP address is essentially so they can stay anonymous online. This means using services on the deep web and dark web through the Tor browser. And if you're going to do that, then you need to make sure that you're properly protected. Now, obviously, it's not just people who are trying to surf the dark web or circumvent geo-blocking that should use a VPN to protect themselves. Essentially, if you've ever used public Wi-Fi, such as at shopping centers or airports or Starbucks, for instance, it's actually not that difficult for anybody with a little bit of technical knowledge, that is, to actually capture all of your data packets that you are sending and receiving. For example, a hacker might be able to intercept and read the emails you're sending and receiving. They can possibly capture usernames and passwords you're typing into, say, banking sites. Or even just recently, actually, there was someone who had logged on to their crypto trading accounts, their Bitcoin account, using a public Wi-Fi. And hackers stole somewhere in the order, I can't remember, it was $100,000 or $155,000 worth of cryptocurrency or Bitcoin that guy had, essentially because that individual didn't protect himself by changing his IP and encrypting his data. Essentially, he wasn't using a VPN. Maybe he was using something else, but it didn't work properly, obviously, and he wasn't properly protected. And for the sake of a few bucks, it wouldn't have cost him over $155,000 or whatever it was. Now, you've heard me mention VPN already a couple of times, so you can probably gather that's the best way to change your IP address and encrypt your traffic. Now, I did say I was going to give you the best and worst, which I will. I'll give you four of those, and I'm going to start off with number one, which, as I mentioned, is the VPN. So a VPN, if you don't already know, is a virtual private network. Essentially, a VPN uses a secure tunnel to connect to a remote server, that is. It also encrypts all of the data that travels through that tunnel, as well as changing your IP address. To be completely protected while using the internet and to change your IP, the best way to do it, as I mentioned, is to use a reliable, really emphasize a reliable VPN with a good industry reputation that's very well reviewed. IP Vanish is the only true top tier VPN service in the world. They deliver the best speeds, the most secure connections, and most competitive pricing anywhere. I will mention they also won the best VPN of 2017 at the T3 Awards. Their VPN network spans some 40,000 plus IPs on 950 servers in over 60 countries. This gives you the ability to be able to surf safely and anonymously, so you can access unrestricted internet in every corner of the globe. To actually change your IP using IP Vanish is super simple. All you need to do is open up the program once you've downloaded it, and essentially all you need to do is just turn it on and your IP address will be changed. You do have the option to pick a country and pick a server in which to do that as well. I'll just give this a second to load up. As I mentioned, all you need to do is just hit the connect button, and that'll change your IP. You'll notice my IP address up here, my current location. I can just change that to Australia, for instance, and you'll see it'll actually change my IP. And that's it, that's connected now, and you can see it's literally just as simple as that, and it's changed my IP and my IP location. To get access to Security Gladiators exclusive 57% discount, make sure you click the link in the description or right about now. There should be a card in the top right hand corner you can click as well, and that'll take you through to the IP Vanish review page, and then you click the link in there and you'll be bought here, and you'll get a 57% discount. As far as I'm aware, that's the cheapest available on the web. Now, the second best way after a VPN to hide or change your IP address is to use a smart DNS. The good thing is that it's quick and easy. However, the major downside is there's absolutely no encryption whatsoever, so essentially leaving you unprotected. Most smart DNS won't actually work if you're trying to use it for Netflix either, whereas the VPN will. You'll also need to log on to the DNS site every time you use the internet from a different location, because it routes your current IP through the new IP, as opposed to IP Vanish, which you just switch on. Changing your IP address using a smart DNS is more complicated than using a VPN. You actually have to go into your settings and change a few things. So you need to right click on your little Wi-Fi symbol in the taskbar. You need to open up network settings and then click on Wi-Fi. This is if you're on Windows 10, that'll be slightly different if you're on another operating system. And then you need to change your adapter settings. Click on that. And then go to your Wi-Fi, right-click Properties. And then you need to find Internet Protocol 4 somewhere in there. Click on that and go to the Properties and use obtain the following DNS server addresses, and that's where you paste the actual IP address that's supplied in Strong VPN. Once you've pasted them in, you actually need to restart your computer for it to activate, and then your IP address will be changed. So it is a little bit more convoluted than a VPN, hence why we recommend that. It's just a whole lot easier. If you decide to use a smart DNS to change your IP, then we'll put a link in the description and you can get a discount as well to use Strong DNS, which is the smart DNS that we recommend. The third way to change your IP address is to use the Tor browser. It's the trusted tool of the dark web community. However, if you're using it for downloading or streaming, it's pretty much useless as it's extremely slow. I will mention that Tor has also just recently been in the news because it's been found out there are actually vulnerabilities within the browser, which have led to people getting arrested. It's led to their IPs becoming exposed. So it's, again, even more of a reason for using a VPN for that extra layer of protection, because you just, honestly, you can't be sure. Now, the fourth and by far the worst way to change your IP is by using a free proxy. It will change your IP, but it's extremely unsafe. And by using a third-party proxy, you have absolutely no control over what happens to your information once it leaves you. To be honest, in many ways, this is even worse than using a public Wi-Fi. And for that reason, we don't recommend it at all. So just to recap, guys, the four ways to change your IP address is one, and our most recommended way is to use a VPN. And the VPN, as I've mentioned, that we recommend is IP Vanish. I'll put a link in the description. You can read the full review here on our site at Security Gladiators, and if you click on the link, you'll get a 57% discount as well. The second way was to use a smart DNS. Now, I'll put a link in the description as well where you'll be able to get a discount. It's not the best way to change your IP, but it is the second best way. The third is to use the Tor, but like I mentioned, there are vulnerabilities with that. So again, we recommend, even if you're using Tor, to use a VPN with it. And the fourth way, and the way we definitely don't recommend, is to use a free proxy site. But again, it's highly insecure and not recommended at all. If you have any questions, hit us up in the comments and be sure to subscribe to our channel. Like this video. And if there's something you don't like about it, let us know. Thanks for watching Security Gladiators.